California has been on fire, quite literally. And again, if you listen to the media explain it, it's all because of global warming or climate change. Now, that's not true. Let's hear from an expert. Chuck DeVore joins us. He's a vice president of national initiatives with a great group, the Texas Public Policy Foundation. Hey, Chuck, thank you, my friend, for joining me. So these horrible fires in, especially the fire in Northern California, we can't just chalk it up, as CNN tells me, to climate change?
Well, that's correct. And it's worse than that, because people's lives are at stake. Many people have died. The last I checked, 4 firefighters, multiple civilian casualties. We owe it to their memory, and we owe it to the citizens of California and other areas in the western United States that are subject to these sorts of fires, to tell the truth about what's happening and to change the policies that have been put in place back during the Clinton administration that have caused and made these fires worse.
Well, and Chuck, the truth, and as you mentioned, the problem is man-caused, and it is a product of government policy. So dig down on that. What is the truth, and what's the policy? What really is going on here?
Well, this has to do with active forest management. This was something that was curtailed in the 1990s in response to concerns, I believe, overblown concerns over the northern spotted owl, an animal that, as we have found out, shares identical DNA characteristics with other similar owls throughout the western United States and down into Mexico. But I think in their drive to make a particular grouping of the owl in the forests of Oregon more special, environmentalists claimed it was its own species and thus sought Endangered Species Act controls that greatly limited the ability of logging companies to actively manage the fuel load, not only on privately owned land, but on federally owned land, owned by the U.S. Forest Service under the Department of Agriculture. And so that began a process that started in the 1990s that built up the fuel load over many, many decades, to the point now where we get fires that are so hot that they literally sterilize the soil. They burn up a lot of the deposited debris over many, many decades. The ground cover actually burns, the topsoil burns, releasing an enormous amount of carbon dioxide into the air, which of course is one of the things that the individuals who prevent us from doing these common sense control techniques argue is the problem. It's actually making more of the gas that they say is the problem. So that's where the history begins, but it even gets more subtle and more insidious than that, depending on how much time you have to go into this with your viewers.
Chuck, continue, because I find this fascinating, and so few people aware of any of this.
Well, first of all, you know, as a former California lawmaker who took it upon himself to educate himself a little more about what was going on in California and other western forests, I started doing some research and asked a bunch of questions about, you know, how did we get here? What's going on? And the first thing that you find is that the Native Americans had a very aggressive campaign of managed burns or controlled burns. It was a program of perhaps 1 million acres a year throughout the West to burn away the forests before they got too thick. And they did so because, of course, the game animals that they hunted didn't really survive all that well in a thick forest. And so what's fascinating to me is that there was a book by a gentleman named Groell, who's probably in his early 90s now, if he's still alive. He's a wildlife biologist. And he went back and looked at photographs from the dawn of photography when the Americans began to settle California shortly after the Gold Rush. And so you have all these photos from the 1850s and 60s showing what California looked like, what the Eastern Sierra and the other heavily wooded areas of today look like. And what you see is you see areas of a lot of grassland, a few isolated stands of pine trees, and a few oak trees, because the Indians were constantly burning the land because that's what they did. Now, when America then settled the area, we didn't like fires because fires burned down towns, plus the timber was valuable. So we began to suppress the fires and manage the forests. We cut down the trees. We put them through the lumber mills, and we built things with them. And then eventually we slowed down and we stopped to doing as much trimming of the trees, as much clearing, of the underbrush and controlled burns and selling of the lumber. And eventually the fuel load began to build up and build up and build up over the last three decades.
Chuck, can I stop you right there?
Yes.
Why did we slow down the cutting of the forest and everything? Why did we slow down?
Right. So again, this is a multi-pronged issue. Number one, of course, the Endangered Species Act and the protection of the spotted owl, where biologists argued that you needed these mature or rotting trees that the owls would roost in, and therefore you couldn't do anything in the forest. So it made it more difficult, more expensive to get in and manage the forest, especially on publicly owned land. Number two, the people who are the government biologists, the government employees, many of them argued with the avid encouragement of the left-wing environmentalists that you weren't to touch public forests, that this was something to be held in trust for future Americans, and we didn't want private companies in there mucking around with forest management techniques. It wasn't natural, so let's not do it anymore. Well, as soon as you start to then have a decline in the timber harvesting, now in California, about 60% of the forest land is controlled by the federal government, the rest being privately owned. And so if the federal government's saying, no, you can't come here, then it makes it very difficult for anyone to suggest, well, let's go do a controlled burn or let's thin the trees out, because without the profit that you would earn by cutting a few of the trees to pay for the cleaning up of the forest, it's extremely expensive. Plus, the federal biologists, the federal bureaucrats, didn't want them in the forest in the first place because they said it's not natural. So these individuals who do this for a living warned that this was coming. I've read reports 15, 20 years old that are clarion calls for what we have seen in the last few years with these extremely intense, very hot fires, which they predicted because of the soaring fuel load. Now, this led to other things. California used to have biofuel plants that would burn the refuse from the forest, the underbrush that was cleared, the wood chips, the small trees, as well as agricultural produce. Now, the air quality folks in California didn't much like this because wood doesn't burn as cleanly as natural gas.
I think I lost you, Chuck. That's just fascinating. So we're not harvesting trees like we once did. We're no longer clearing brush and thinning trees. Are you back there, Chuck? We lost them. Just fascinating. No, I want to get Chuck back on. That is absolutely fascinating. This is a recurring problem. That was wonderful. Thank you, Chuck. Thank you. Our gallery of the stupid coming up next. Don't go anywhere.